下面来关注社区方面消息。少数族裔媒体服务机构 EMS 于9月4号举办研讨会，专家们就社会的法治以及激进右团体对社会影响等问题进行了讨论。
前联邦调查局前自由与国家安全中心研究员 Michael German 称，在执法部门中依然有种族主义存在，包括白人至上和极右激进组织。在公共场合和社交媒体上公开的种族主义活动，通过在1990年对类似组织的调查发现，执法人员如检察官等公开参与有组织的种族主义团体，让本应该被公平对待的人受到伤害。他称，联邦调查局多年来一直承认白人至上主义团体与执法部门之间存在联系，这样的现象是美国存在的结构性偏见，产生某种类型的执法领导者，比如执法部门，尤其是联邦执法部门和许多州的地方执法机构。这些机构的领导人绝大多数是白人，绝大多数是男性，结构性偏见将白人至上主义在权力的加持下发扬光大。从警察拦截、搜查、逮捕、枪击和其他武力使用，到指控决定、错误定罪和判决，一套体系让人们看到长期存在对种族、经济和社会不平等所造成的对有色人种的结构性和体制上的偏见。
Today, the FBI can't tell you how many people white supremacists killed in the United States last year, or 5 years ago, or 10 years ago, because they don't take that data. What we were discussing was the terrorism watch list.So anybody who is a subject of a terrorism investigation at the FBI is put on the terrorism watch list. This is problematic in a number of different ways, but the FBI argues that it's necessary to put these individuals on a watch list.
Mothers in Charge 负责人 Dorothy Johnson Spate 称，全美的枪支暴力问题日益严重。在费城仅7月份，当地至少有24人被枪杀，其中包括2名儿童和1名妇女。据警方报告，今年截止日8月，费城已有1139人遭枪击，较去年同期增长了36%，是自上世纪90年代以来最高速增长。
Being a black man driving a nice car, being stopped because you're perceived as a criminal.You know, things like that are difficult to live with, and it's a fear that we have. And I talk to even mothers today, especially with what's going on today in our communities, where young black men and women are shot down. There's police brutality going on in ways that we never knew about before, unless you were personally involved. But now we begin to see it differently.You know, believe about it differently. Maybe believe before that, oh, it happens now and then. No, it doesn't happen now and then. You know, it happens all the time. There are patterns that continue to happen in communities of color.
根据调查机构的分析，今年的受害者中至少有102名未成年人，这个数字很快就会超过去年全年被枪击的儿童总数。凤凰卫视陈家红，洛杉矶报道。